Let's talk about ulcerative colitis, a very nasty condition where you have inflammation in your colon, which is the last part of your digestive tract, and the rectum, with ulcers, with bleeding. And the problem is there's only really two solutions medically. One is surgery, and the other one is steroids. So I don't like these two solutions, because as soon as you do the steroids, you might feel better, but then the next time you do it, you need more and more and more and more until the point where you become resistant to steroids. And it has a lot of side effects as well. And of course, surgery is not the ultimate solution, because the purpose of the colon is to absorb water and electrolytes. So if you're not able to reabsorb water and recycle water, you're going to be dehydrated, not to mention the importance of electrolytes as well on the heart. Also, the colon houses most of your microbiome. So if you don't have that flora there to help you make vitamins, help your immune system, you're going to have a lot of issues and a lot of skin issues as well. So I want to give you some other things to do naturally to help if you have ulcerative colitis. It's an autoimmune condition, which means that your own immune system is creating a constant irritation and inflammation to the colon, creating ulcers. So the most important thing, if you're new to my channel, maybe this is a new thing to you. If you're not, this is what you need to do: fasting. Fasting is the most important thing. When you eat 6 meals a day, this is very, very bad for ulcerative colitis, because you never give it a chance to heal. So fasting will drop inflammation. It'll increase the diversity of your microbiome, okay? Which is interesting. You're gonna not feed these microbes, but then they become more diverse, they become stronger, they survive better. If you feed them too much, they get lazy and fat. Also, you'll have an increase in something called small chain fatty acids. And this is an anti-inflammatory compound, and it helps with insulin resistance, it helps with your immune system. So fasting is very, very important. If you're new to my channel, I put a link down below of how to do intermittent fasting and periodic prolonged fasting. Number two, zinc. Zinc is necessary for any type of ulcers. So if you have a zinc deficiency, it increases your risk of getting an ulcer. So you want zinc. Number three, vitamin D. And I know you've probably heard this many, many times. In fact, I had one comment today on one of my YouTube videos that said, Dr.Berg, do you recommend fasting and vitamin D for every single condition? And I said, just about, simply because it's very, very important. And if the condition involves inflammation, which is a large percentage of conditions, then these two things are necessary. So vitamin D in higher amounts, and I'm talking about 40,000 IUs per day, maybe even more for ulcerative colitis. Vitamin D is an immune modulator. It controls the immune system. It helps to put the fire out. It's a very powerful anti-inflammatory, and it acts like cortisone and prednisone, but without the side effects. So this is very, very important. Cabbage juice has some interesting research. I'll put a link down below. In fact, I'll put a link down below for all the research that I'm talking about right now. Cabbage juice, certain phytonutrients in cabbage juice has known properties to help with ulcers and gastritis and any type of damage in your colon, especially inflammation. In fact, if you have ulcerative colitis or celiac or some type of inflammation in your gut, cabbage as a vegetable seems to be something you probably will be able to digest more than other vegetables. But for a great majority of people, consuming vegetables will irritate their colon. So in that case, they have to go more carnivore for a while, maybe 2 months, maybe longer, to help reset and heal the colon, because the fiber acts to irritate the colon. But they might do fine with cabbage. But the cabbage juice is something you can actually take. So you want to juice it fresh. All right, number five, VSL number three. This is a very powerful probiotic. You can get it from the health food store. You can get it online. There's 8 strains. You would want to take 4 to 8 capsules. Not right away. You take a very small amount initially and gradually work up to it, because it can create an immune reaction. but it has a count of 900 billion compared to other probiotics, which at the very most, it'd be like 20 billion. So it's super concentrated. And you'd have to take it for at least a month, 2 months to really start seeing the change because it's a slow process. It's lactose free, but it's very, very powerful for ulcerative colitis and any type of inflammatory condition. Wheatgrass juice powder has also some interesting studies that I'm going to put down below to help with any type of lesions, inflammation, ulcers on the internal part of your skin, the lining either in the esophagus, the stomach, the small intestine, the large intestine, or apple cider vinegar. Wheatgrass juice and wheatgrass juice powder is very beneficial to help the inner skin of the gut. So I think really if you did these things right here, you'll be in a lot better shape, and there's very minimal side effects of these items right here. So give it a shot and comment down below. Before you go, if you have a question about a product, or you're new to keto and you want to know how to begin keto, or you're on keto and you need a debug because it's not going as smooth, I have a keto consultant standing by to help you. This is just for the people in the US. Hopefully in the future we'll be able to answer everyone's call. But I put the number down below so you can call and get some help.